Thank you for joining us this afternoon. I'm Carolyn Long. More than 10 million Americans have been infected with COVID-19 since the pandemic began. That includes more than 1 million new cases since the end of October. That's the worst stretch of infection so far in this country. And nearly half of the cases, 46%, came from the Midwest. The United States is consistently seeing new infections in excess of 100,000 per day. And the new average daily death toll is around 950 Americans. Kansas and Missouri are contributing to this as well. The Sunflower State reported another massive spike, recording nearly 6,000 new infections since last Friday. Democratic Governor Laura Kelly and legislative leaders have launched a campaign to encourage mask use. However, it's still running into resistance. Now, the toll of the virus is also being felt on the Missouri side, with an average case count near 3,500 new infections and 9 deaths daily. Here locally, doctors from KU Med held their daily briefing. They revealed that they, too, are seeing an influx of patients, with at least 25 in the ICU. It's especially challenging during this busy time of year, and the hospital is weighing its options now to keep up.
This is the busiest time of the year for us. And now we have 108 more patients in because of COVID, and those patients are sick. So what are the things you can do? We can stop taking transfers from outside hospitals, which we've had to slow that down. I think that's not the best answer, right? Because that hurts patients who need you.
Another option under consideration is stopping elective surgeries. Still, doctors say the number one thing that needs to happen is mask use. They heard from one survivor who shared her incredible experience after her entire family caught the virus, except for her immunocompromised son.
But we were really good about masking and gloves when we went in to take care of him. He's completely dependent on us. And the fact that he didn't get it from all of us in the house that had it just showed me, really drove home the point that wearing your mask, social distancing, you know, good hand hygiene and clean, you know, cleaning the high touch items really proved to me that that's the best way to stop this.
Doctors say they're about 30 patients away from having to make some very difficult decisions.